Hello, my dear students of class 5th. In this video, I am making specially for you. In this video, I am going to tell you the solution of the toughest question currently you are facing, rather than any question from the subject. Okay, the question is how to write on the answer sheet. You know, this year you have to write on separate answer sheet. There will be separate question paper and separate answer sheets. So how to write, or what care should be taken while writing on the answer sheet, that I am going to tell you in this video. Please watch this video very carefully. Okay, so let's go for it. This is your answer sheet. We have provided answer sheets to you, so the answer sheet will be like this. Okay, there are total 8 pages. Okay, 8 pages. There are total 8 pages. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Okay, so this answer sheet is made up of 8 pages. Okay, now this is the first page of your answer sheet. On the first page, you will observe some columns and some blanks. In that, at that place, you have to write all your details. Now we'll go point by point. See here, Rotary Pratishthan's Rotary English Medium School, Kher. Kher, this is pin code, district Ratnagiri, Maharashtra. This everything is about a school. This is school name. Okay, then below that, name of the exam. Name of the exam means you have to write the name of this exam. Means this is summative assessment 1, or so SA S.A.1. okay, SA1. Here you have to write educational year 2020 2021, in this way. Okay, after that, here roll number, you have to write your roll number. Suppose your roll number is 1, then you have to write in this way 01. Your name, suppose your name is Master Omkar Vinayak Kaste. I'm taking Kaste's name. Okay, you have to write your name here. Then your class, class is suppose 5th, and your sections, SEC dot, that means it is section. 5th section means your division, 5th Sambodh. Okay, or whatever your division may be, it may be Pythagoras or Pravinya. Then date, here you have to write the date of your paper. Suppose your paper, particular paper, is on 27th October, then 27 10 2020. Okay, subject, suppose subject is Marathi. Okay, then subject code. Here see, subject code, you don't have to write any code here because you don't know subject code, and here not necessary for you. This is for 10th standard student. Okay, this is not for you. So just simply put dash there. Then number of supplements used, 1+. So this point you have to write at the end of the paper. So now skip it. Okay, then signature of invigilator. Signature of invigilator means what? Signature of supervisor. And now for this exam, the supervisor will be your parents, your father or mother, whoever present is there is present, they will sign here. If parents are watching this video, please pay attention. You have to sign here in front of signature of invigilator, in front of this point. Okay, then there is one table. Okay, then in that section A B C D, all this is not for you, this is for teacher. Okay, then from here the actual answer sheet which you have to write on which you have to write, that start from here. Please start writing from this page. Means you will think that yes, there are only some lines, so can we start to write from the next page? No, you have to start write from here, from this page. Okay, then now once your question paper reading over, No, you will not get question paper first. First, what you have to do after writing everything, these details, you have to take scale or that means ruler, and you have to draw here margin, lines for margin this way. Total 3 lines you have to draw. 3 lines means 2 columns, okay? 1 and 2, 3 lines, okay? In this way. In this way, you have to draw a margin for on all pages, okay, till here. Leave proper space here, because when teacher will check, she has to give marks here. Teacher has to give marks, write marks here, so leave space here, okay, and then draw 3 lines. So that your margin is ready. Now, after reading whole question paper, first you have to read whole question paper. Then after reading whole question paper, the question paper will be divided into sections. Section A, Section B, Section C and Section D. Okay. So, according to the sequence, Section A is of 1 mark, Section B 2 marks, Section C 3 marks, Section D 4 marks. Okay. So, comparatively A is easiest, okay? So generally most of students start Section A first. So if you are going to start Section A first, then you write here Section A, okay? If you think that Section B is easier for you, you can start Section B. But once you start Section B here, you have to complete entire section and then you have to move towards the next section, okay? If you are starting B, if you are starting A here, then also you have to complete all questions from Section A and then you have to move towards Section B. So take that care. Now here is Section A you are starting, then question 1 in Section A, the question 1 is this way. Question 1 you would write in this way. Question 1, suppose in case there are sub questions in question 1, there are sub questions, question 1 A, question, then you would write this way. Question 1 A, B, C, D, this way, okay? If there are fill in the blanks, then you'll write only the word. If the question is like this, what is name of your school? The first question 1A is, what is name of your school, okay? Then you don't have to write question here. You have to write only answers. Understood? So you will write in this way. The question is, what is name of your school? Then you will write in front of this A, you will write the name of my school is Rotary English Medium School Khed. I am giving this for example. Okay, then you write question B, whatever question will be there, its answer you write here. Understood? Question 1A over, then question 2 is here you write question 2. In that, suppose A is there, then you write answer here, then B, then C, okay? Then suppose your section A completed here, section A completed here, finished till here, your section A got completed. Then you have to write, you have to start now section B. So if you think that yes, there is space here, so we can start section B here. No, don't. If your section A is getting completed here, then don't start section B here. Leave this space as it is. Start your section B on the new page. Okay, here. Okay, section B. In that, suppose question 3 A, whatever, here you write question 3 A, whatever questions are asked, in that way you have to write. In maths paper directly you have to write question 1, question 2, question 3. There are no sub questions. okay. So whatever questions are asked in the question paper, in the way the question paper questions are asked in the question paper, in that way only you have to write here. Put proper number of question paper, that is very important, so that teacher will check properly or teacher will not get suffer while checking. Okay, then see section B started here. Then suppose you completed section B here, then section C started here. So while writing section C or any section, if your answer sheets get finished, all 8 pages of answer sheet finished, and still your paper is remain, still you have to write answers of some questions, then what to do? You have been given supplements. See here, this is called supplement, extra page. So you will use the supplement to write the remaining questions, answers of remaining questions. Okay, so there will be stamp here, stamp of school. Then here you write your roll number, name and roll number, sorry, name and roll number. And you will take here sign of parents. Sign of parents, why? Means sign of supervisor, okay? You have to take here. Understood? Then you will write on the supplement. Suppose you have taken 3 supplements for this paper, okay? And your paper get completed. Then what? After that, at the end, what you have to do? Suppose you have taken 3 supplements, then here number of supplements used, 1 plus 3. 1 means this one for one answer sheet and 3 supplements. So 1 plus 3, total 4. Okay, here you write at the end. After that, you have been given thread. This is the thread. You have to bind the paper in this way. Okay, in this way you will tie your paper. Understood? So this care we have to take while writing the answers on the separate answer sheet. Okay, I think all your doubts are cleared now. So even though if you have any doubt, you can contact your class teacher. Okay, thank you for everyone for watching this video.